Thank you for this day and for the continued opportunity to join together to help fulfill a promise made by Nancy G. Brinker to her sister Susan G. Bowman to end breast cancer forever. In these challenging times, when we are separated from loved ones, families, and friends, let us persevere in our determination to create a healthy and loving world. Let us not forget that the obstacles overcome today become the steps that lead us to where we want to go. Mahalo nui for our sponsors, all the participants and their families and friends, and our volunteers who, with combined energies and efforts, continue to make this event a success. We ask a special blessing for all the survivors, and we celebrate the memory of those who are no longer with us. Finally, we ask that everyone be kept safe throughout this day and until we meet again with this traditional Hawaiian prayer of continued health and a prayer for those who are ailing. Laila la dia kuoya ukia loa ke. Ai mano ino ni. O kapu o kani mayana o kona lua ki. Ina e ke kamali iki lelena o hanae. Eko, eko, eke kia, au e lono e, ua ola e. Amama, ua noa.
Everyone, I'm Candace, your host for the Susan G. Komen Opening Ceremony, Live from Home Edition. Today's a beautiful day for a power-packed race walk, a day to come together as one to rally around our mission of ending breast cancer.
No matter the elements, we know nothing would stop this community from getting out there and making a difference.
My co-host, everyone.
I'm your co-host, Katie. We're so glad you're here.
Also, Katie, I thought we were going with the other shirt. Now I feel underdressed.
I know. But the truth is, yesterday was One Friday Fun Day, and I just couldn't decide between that outfit or today's.
So you went with both?
Yeah, I went with both.
Is that vintage Komen?
It sure is. But don't worry, because I brought you one. It's right here in the bag.
Here?
Yep.
I love it. How cute is this? Is this my prize for completing my Power of One bingo card?
It sure is. Let's see in the chat who else has completed their cards this week. Candace, can I get some love on my victory selfie?
On it. Wow, look at all the tagged photos from Power of One Week. I've been checking out the One Community Photo Gallery online almost every day now, and I still can't get enough.
I know, right? If you haven't checked it out yet, you can go to komen.org/photos and scroll through the different hashtags, and you'll be able to narrow it down.
And don't stop sharing your pics. For everyone posting from the finish line or cheering from the sidelines, the hashtags are on the screen now. Katie?
You get a vintage tee? You get a vintage tee, but they're only yours for the day. Those are collector's items. You can't get them anywhere.
Oh, you're so sweet, Katie.
I'm always here for the One community. I've been collecting these shirts since I started participating in the Komen Walks, and I keep them to remind me of all the survivors and co-survivors that I've met along the way.
That's what's so amazing about how active this One community has been leading up to event day. We came together taking action every day to fund one mission of ending breast cancer. And now, on event day, we're coming together as one yet again.
We know you all shared your stories during My One Tuesday, but keep sharing them. These are the stories that keep us fighting every day.
And to thank you for contributing to the Komen mission, we have a few people who want to share some words of inspiration and gratitude for your fundraising efforts before you get out there. Welcome to the Mission Minute, and hello to our guests who are joining us before heading out for their own race or walk today to discuss the impact of breast cancer research, care, community, and action.
Thank you, Candace and Katie, and all of our panelists and our walkers and our fundraisers and our wonderful sponsors. I'm Paula Schneider. I'm the CEO of Susan G. Komen. Not only am I a breast cancer survivor and a mother of two adult girls, but I lost my mom to metastatic breast cancer. And I have to say how grateful and honored I am to be here today. The work this One community does inspires me every single day. You're the reason we continue to get one step closer to realizing our vision of a world without breast cancer. Now, I'm excited to hear more from each of our panelists who represent in their own way the four pillars of our One mission.
My name is Donald McDonald, and I'm a breast cancer researcher. I'm walking today and working every day in the lab to make the hope of a world without breast cancer a reality. In my lab, my colleagues and I are focusing on why some breast cancers come back or recur and why they spread to other parts of the body. But when they do, we want to find cures for these cancers. Thanks to the work of Komen in funding through events like today, we are able to give those living with metastatic breast cancer the hope of new discoveries that will result in new, more effective treatments that will be available when they need it.
Hi, I'm Fiani Jackson, and I work at Susan G. Komen as a breast cancer patient navigator. It is my job to help navigate people through the complicated healthcare system and to make sure that they have all the support that they need to stay in the continuum of their care. I walk for all the women and men I serve and help every day to make sense of their disease and to make sure that they get the care they need throughout their personal breast cancer journey.
My name is Roxana Guerra, and I'm living with metastatic breast cancer, and I walk for myself and my son. He was 6 years old when I was first diagnosed, and he's been my strength and my motivation to be fighting every single day.
My name is Nicole DeSorette, and I'm a Komen advocate and ambassador. I walk to educate lawmakers and legislators about issues that impact cancer care. I want to make sure that our one voice is heard loud and clear.
It's hard to deny the impact we're having based on what everyone has had to share so far. And yeah, we often talk a lot about the numbers, such as how many research projects and clinical trials that your fundraising makes possible, or the number of resources we have available to people facing breast cancer today, or how many pieces of legislation we've been able to push across the finish line and see become law. And all of that is true and very important. But what I want our racers and walkers to realize today is that Komen is able to ensure that no one faces breast cancer alone. You have continued to walk every year. You and the Komen community have fundraised and donated upwards of $3 billion since our founding nearly four decades ago. So when you're out there rallying with your community today, I want you to think about the incredible impact each and every one of you have made for our families, the mothers, the sisters, the best friends, and the men who have been touched by breast cancer. Remember that you, as one person, are contributing to the one community that is going to save lives today and for years to come. One more step walked means a difference. One more story shared creates impact. One more dollar raised truly counts.
I could not agree more. Congratulations to all of you. Let's hear it one more time in the chat. And thank you again to our national sponsors, Bank of America and Walgreens, as well as our local sponsors. You're just as much a part of this one community as anyone else. It's your stories that bring us together and your stories that push us to take one step further for those living with breast cancer. And speaking of those who inspire us most, don't forget to tune in to the One Audio Experience, where we have a bunch more impactful and empowering stories for you to listen to while you're walking or whenever you need a healthy dose of inspiration.
Trust me, I've already listened to a few stories and the inspiration is real. You can find the link in your pre-event email and you can listen to it on any podcast streaming platform. And on top of the audio experience, your community has a handful of amazing engagements planned to help you create the best One Community moments this year. So be sure to check off all of the activities on your list, which you should have also received in your pre-event email. We suggest you print it or download it to your phone to keep it handy as you make your way through all of the exciting activities.
And don't forget to post your final finish line moment, which you'll find as a separate link in your pre-event email and as the final item in your activity list. You have one more month from today to keep up the fundraising. Let's make the next 4 weeks of fundraising and the rest of 2021 count. Now we know you all want to get out there and walk, and we do too. Katie's been stretching for the past 5 minutes. So have fun today, stay hydrated, and remember that each of us makes a difference when we come together as one.
My name's Lindsay McLaughlin, and when I was 28, I was diagnosed with invasive ductal carcinoma breast cancer.
I'm Sheila, and I'm a survivor. I fought for this country, and I fought breast cancer.
I'm Antoinette, and I am a survivor.
Aloha and good morning, Hawaii. I'm Rolanda Morgan, Executive Director of Susan G. Komen Hawaii. Thank you for joining us this morning and tuning in from your home, your neighborhood, or wherever you are, as we come together as one community for the Susan G. Komen Race for the Cure, where every step we take individually has the collective power to save lives and brings us closer to a world without breast cancer. As you heard in our event day kickoff video from Komen CEO Paula Schneider, the actions we take, big and small, individually and collectively, are things the Susan G. Komen does here in Hawaii and from coast to coast. We are bold, we are fearless, and we are dedicated to research, care, community, and action. And by joining forces together, you as members of our one community have a real impact. I'm here today to once again tap into the power of community, which lifted me, held my hand, provided the best treatment, and supported my recovery when I faced my own diagnosis and the moments that changed my life forever. This year, I celebrated my 10th year as a survivor. I would now like to introduce Dr. Angela Pratt, Hawaii KLC member and presenting sponsor, to provide a short welcome message. Angela?
Aloha, I'm Dr. Angela Pratt, Komen Hawaii Leadership Council member and presenting sponsor for Race for the Cure. I'm here with my mom, Barbara Pratt, a breast cancer survivor. Thank you for being a part of our one community. The impact you are making with fundraising is undeniable. Your actions are providing funds to support critical, groundbreaking research while ensuring that no one experiences barriers to care. Thank you for everything you have done and continue to do. We hope you have a fantastic day as you race. Don't forget to post your photos and share your experience with our community using hashtag OneColeman or hashtag RaceForTheCure.
The Race for the Cure brings the One community together, even when we are apart, to recognize and be inspired by those who have been diagnosed with breast cancer and are living with the disease. These are the loved ones and friends and the reason most of us are here today, to support them and raise the critical dollars so no one must face breast cancer alone in the future. And because each of our actions count, and every cancer story has the power to inspire, we would now like to share one of those stories with you today.
Hi, my name is Laurie Merkulier, and I am a cancer survivor. Before I even start telling you about my story, I need to tell you why I am here and thriving even with cancer. And that's because of my family. They made it easy for me to focus on myself and not have to worry about anything else but getting better. They have been there from day one, and I know they will continue to be there with me for the rest of this journey, however long it might be. Along with my family, I need to say thank you to my friends, the doctors, nurses, and everybody included in the medical team that have been there, and they have been nothing short of amazing. So thank you. And lastly, I need to thank the community, people I know, people I don't know, just for keeping me in your prayers. You don't know how much that really means to me. And from all of that support, that has what kept me going through this whole thing. So thank you. My journey started earlier this year, back in February, when I was diagnosed with breast cancer. And cancer is a word no one really wants to hear about. But luckily for me, I met someone from the Susan G. Komen Hawaii branch early on, and she told me this one piece of advice that I've kept with me, and that is, I am a cancer survivor from the day of diagnosis. So with that, I got through chemo, I had my lumpectomy, I'm doing radiation, and although my journey might seem like it's over, it will continue, it will be a lifestyle change, but nothing I can't handle with the support of everybody around me. Earlier this month, my daughter did her third hair donation, and it was great for her to see full circle what it really does. So with that being done, and being that it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month, I decided to ditch the wig. Although I'm very open about my story and I love to spread awareness, I wore the wig so I could keep a normal life and people wouldn't feel sorry for me. I was just interacting with everybody as if I didn't have cancer. And believe it or not, this whole journey has been a positive thing for me. A lot of people always ask, why me? Why did this happen to me? What did I do? But for me, I turned it into a positive thing. And I think my reason for getting it is because I am so strong and I don't dwell on the negative. I think my reason I got it is because I can continue to share and hopefully inspire and raise awareness about breast cancer. And I can do this now even more. Thank you to Susan G. Komen Hawaii branch for giving me that voice.
Thank you, Laurie, for sharing your story. Her story is only one of the hundreds of stories that make up the breast cancer community. While we celebrate those who have survived and support and motivate those who are in the midst of their treatment, we recognize how far we've come in the fight against breast cancer. But we also recognize how far we still have to go. We are still losing friends and loved ones to this terrible disease, which means we need to keep fundraising. So don't forget that you can still raise essential dollars until November 14th, 2021. It is in these moments of action and commitment that together we can change the course of the disease today and for future generations.
Speaking of commitment, Susan G. Komen receives tremendous support from our generous family of sponsors. I want to give a special shout out to the national presenting sponsor, Bank of America, and national series sponsor, Walgreens, who support our One Communities and Races for the Cure across the country. Thank you to our local presenting sponsors, Hawaii News Now and Summit Media, and top sponsors, the Safeway Foundation, Macy's, and the Queens Health Systems. Thanks to all our sponsors. You see all their names and logos on the screen. And of course, this awesome event would not be possible without the leadership, the dedication, and dedication of all our event committee volunteers who represent the heart of what we do. Mahalo. We know it takes determination, love, support, and science to fight breast cancer. And it also takes money. That's why we're so thankful that all of you who raised funds, funds that are essential in keeping and helping Komen support people in our One Community and in every community every day. I am proud to announce that so far, this community has raised $60,400. This is an amazing and would not have been possible without each of you making that commitment to fundraise for a world without breast cancer. We want to recognize some of you who took the commitment to the cause one step further and pushed to raise $1 more. And it shows. Now it's my pleasure to announce the top three fundraising teams and individuals for the Komen Hawaii Race for the Cure as of October 14th. The number three fundraising team, raising $3,227, is the Breasty Bunch. The number two team, raising $505,000, My Boobs Were Made for Walking. And the top fundraising team here in Hawaii is Team Dr. Pratt, raising $5,250. Now on to individual fundraisers. With $1,500 raised, Linda LaFragiola. Our number two individual fundraiser with $2,500 raised, Linda Marcoulier. We just heard her story of strength and power. And our top fundraiser here in Hawaii as an individual is Dr. Angela Pratt, raising $5,200. Wow. Congratulations and thank you to our top fundraisers, teams, and everyone who has been fundraising. Thank you for joining us this morning and coming together for the Susan G. Komen Race for the Cure. Throughout today's event, please share your stories and those you love that have been impacted by breast cancer and why you are committed to this cause. I stated at the beginning and I will say it again, we are bold, we are fearless, and we are dedicated to research, care, community, and action. And by joining forces together, you as members of our One Community are making an impact. Are you ready to get started? Remember, let's fill today with our commitment as one to create a better tomorrow. Let's give support and hope to our neighbors in need, and let's show that we are a passionate community of action. Let's start the 2021 Susan G. Komen Race for the Cure. Have a wonderful day, and thank you. Aloha.